Dear friends, welcome to the class of data structure. This lecture we are going to study about bubble sort. Again, the complexity of bubble sort is order of n square, but if we optimize the algorithm, we can achieve complexity of order of n if the array is already sorted. That can be treated as the best case. So let's explore bubble sort. So as you can see in the algorithm, it requires total n passes. Okay, and in every pass what we do, adjacent elements are compared. So j is compared with j plus 1, and if j is greater, we interchange, we swap j and j plus 1. So what happens basically after first pass, the maximum element is placed at last index. It means it go to its proper place. After second pass, the second max element is placed at second last index, and so on. So in third pass, after third pass, third maximum element will be placed at the third last index, and similarly at the end array will get sorted. So let's explore the algorithm with the help of an example. Before that, if you can see this inner loop, so it is running for j is equal to 0 to n minus 1 minus k. Okay, so every time the number of comparison is going to reduce, like what we are doing in first pass when k is equal to 0, we have n elements here. Okay, and we are comparing at k is equal to 1, we have n minus 1 elements. When k is equal to 2, we will have n minus 2 elements, and so on. So in every pass, number of elements to be compared will decrease by 1, and eventually we will get a single element to compare. So this is how bubble sort work. So at every pass, we will be comparing the adjacent element, and if the value at j is greater than value at j plus 1, will interchange aj and aj plus 1. So let's understand with the help of an example. So as you can see in this figure, this is our unsorted array. So let it be k. So when k is equal to 0, j will run from 0 to 6. Why? Because j is running from n minus 1 to k. It's running from 0 to n minus 1 minus k. So value of n here is 8. So 8 minus 1 and minus k is equal to 0. It is running from for 7 times. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 times j will execute. So we'll compare aj and aj plus 1. So when j is equal to 0, we are comparing 5 with 3. And since 3 is smaller, we are exchanging 5 and 3. Then when j is equal to 1, we are comparing 5 and 1, and since 1 is smaller, we are again exchanging. When j is equal to 2, we are comparing 5 and 9, that is 2 and 3, j and j plus 1, and again, since no change because 5 is already smaller. When j is equal to 3, we are comparing 9 and 8, that is aj and aj plus 1, and since 8 is smaller, we have swapped. Okay, and when j is equal to 4, we are comparing this 4th element with 5th element, and since 2 is smaller, it is swapped. When j is equal to 5, again we are comparing 5 fifth element with 6th element, j and j plus 1, 4 is smaller, it is swapped. And when j is equal to 6, eventually we are comparing 6th and 7th element, that is j and j plus 1, and then 7 is smaller, it is swapped. So after completion of pass 1, that means that when k is equal to 0, after this first pass, the maximum element, the largest element, got its proper place, that is the last index of the array. Now k will be equal to 1. Here k is analogous to I. I have taken k in algorithm, so I am treating I as k. So when k is equal to 1, again j will run for n minus 1 minus k, that is equal to 8 minus 1 minus 1, that is equal to 6 times. So 0 to 5, j is running for 6 times. Again we will compare 3 and 1. So since 1 is smaller, exchange. Again we compare 3 and 5, no change. Again we compare 5 and 8, no change. Again we compare 8 and 2, the swapped. Again we compare 8 and 4. So since 4 is smaller, swapped. So after execution of second pass, when we compare 8 and 7, after execution of second pass, the second largest element got at its proper place, that is at the second last index. Now k is equal to 2. So j will run from 0 to n minus 1 minus k, that is equal to 8 minus 1 minus 2, that is equal to 5 times, so 0 to 4. Again we'll compare 1 3, no change, 3 5, no change, 2 5, we have a change here, so 5 2, and 5 4, again we have a change here, 4 5, and 5 7, so no change. So after execution of third pass, the third largest element is at its proper place, that is at the third last index. Again, k will be incremented, k is equal to 3, so j will run from 0 to n minus 1 minus 3, that is equal to 8 minus 4, that is equal to 4 times, so 0 1 2 3, 0 1 2 3. Again, we'll compare 1 and 3, no change. We compare 3 and 2, we exchange. We compare 3 and 4, no change. We compare 4 and 5, so no change. So after the fourth pass, fourth largest element is at its proper place. Then k is equal to 5, so j will run from 0 to n minus 1 minus k, that is equal to 8 minus 1 minus 5, that is equal to 4 here, so 8 minus 5, that is equal to 3 times, so 0 1 2, again 1 and 2, no change, 2 and 3, no change, 3 and 4, no change. So after execution of this fifth pass, the fifth largest element is at its proper place now. Now k will be equal to 5. So j run from 0 to n minus k minus 1, that is equal to 8 minus 5 minus 1, is equal to 2 times, so 0, 1. Again we compare 1, 2, no change, 2, 3, no change. So now sixth largest element is at its proper place. Finally, k is equal to 6, so j is going to run from 0 to 8 minus 1 minus 6, that is equal to 1 time, so it's 0, so 1 and 2, no change, so second largest element is now, the seventh largest element is now at its proper place. And finally, we got the sorted array, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 5, 7, 8, and 9. So this is how bubble sort works. So as you can see, in first pass, we have total n elements. Then we worked on n minus 1 element. Then we worked on n minus 2 element. Then we worked on n minus 3 element, and so on. So this is how bubble sort works. So let's understand once again clearly with the help of an example. So this is the ball sort algorithm that will work, that we are working on. So let's take an array. Okay. So when k is equal to 0, j is going to run from 0 to n minus k minus 1, that is equal to 0 to 4 minus 0 minus 1 is equal to 3 times. So first we are going to compare 5 and 7. Since 5 is smaller, will change. Then we are going to compare 7 and 4. Since 4 is smaller, will change. Then we are going to compare 7 and 3. So since 3 is smaller, will change. So this is the end of pass 1. 3 times, 3 comparisons. So now the maximum element is at its proper place. Now pass 2, k is equal to 1. So j will run from 0 to n minus k minus 1, that is equal to 4 minus 1 minus 1 2 times. So 0 to 2 it will run. So this much array will be considered. So again 7 is at its proper place. So now we are comparing 5 and 4. So 4 and 5, 3. The 7 is already at its proper place. Then we are comparing 3 and 5. So 4, 3, 5, 7 is at its proper place. So it executed. And finally, the second last element is now, second largest element is now at its proper place. Now pass 3, when k is equal to 2, j will run from 0 to n minus k minus 1, that is equal to 0 to 4 minus 2 minus 1, that is equal to 1 time only. So what we are going to do here is, this is at its proper place, this is at its proper place. We are going to compare 3 and 4, and finally what we get is, now this is at its proper place. So since we have single element in the list, no comparison is required, and now our array is sorted. So this is how bubble sort works. One thing to remember is that even if the array is sorted, the time complexity will remain n square. Why? See, because what we are doing every time, if you can see here, if we have total n elements, so at first pass we are doing n minus 1 comparisons, then in second pass we are doing n minus 2 comparisons, then n minus 3 comparisons, and so on. So obviously this is proportional to order of n square. So even if the array is sorted, because even if the array is sorted, then also the inner loop is not going to know that array is already being sorted. So I'm taking one more example. Let's see. For this case, so suppose this is the array 1, 2, and 3. Okay, and suppose array is like this. So we are going to compare this element. In first pass we have to do 3 comparisons, so 2 and 1 we compared and we got 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we compare 2, 3, no change. Then we compare 3, 4, no change. So after pass 1, array is sorted. But there is no method here, no instruction here which can tell us now that array is sorted. So again k will be incremented to 1 and again we will do all the comparisons. Again k will be equal to 2 and we'll do all the comparisons. So no logic is there to terminate the array if we get a sorted array. But again, if we want to achieve a best case time complexity of order of n, that is when array is sorted, we can modify our bubble sort algorithm so that the inner loop never works if no swapping is done inside the loop. Like in pass 2, when k was equal to 1, there is no swapping done. So if no swapping done, it means that array is sorted. So we should have some logic here so that we are not going for further swaps. So this will eventually reduce the number of comparisons even if array is not sorted and it is uniformly distributed. And in case the array is sorted, we can achieve time complexity of order of n. So let's see modified bubble sort, or we can call it optimized bubble sort algorithm. So this is the optimized bubble sort algorithm. Here we have taken a variable swapped and initially it is false. And whenever there is a swap, even a single swap inside the inner loop, then we put swap is equal to true, otherwise swap will remain false. And at every value of k, for every value of k, we will check if swap is false or true. If swap is false, we'll exit the algorithm. So let's check it on a sorted array. Okay. So k is equal to 0, j is going to exclude from 0 to n minus k minus 1, that is equal to 0 to 4 minus 0 minus 1 3 times. So k is equal to 0, j is equal to 0. So we compared 11 and 19, no swap. So initially swapped was equal to false, so no swap here, swap is still false. J is equal to 1. We compare 19 and 20, again no swap is there, swap is still false. J is equal to 2. We compare 20 and 36, again no swap is there, the swap is also equal to false. We came out of inner loop and we checked whether swap is equal to false, so condition is true, so we'll break. It means we exit the algorithm, and total number of comparisons done here is n minus 1. So for n size, n input size, we have n minus 1 comparisons only if the array is sorted. So in this case, in this way, we can achieve a time complexity of order of n when the array is sorted and can be considered as best case. So complexity analysis, as we have already seen, if we are using optimized bubble sort, time complexity is always order of n square. However, we can reduce number of comparisons by using optimized bubble sort. So best case occurs when array is already sorted. Using optimized algorithm, we can achieve complexity of order of n. Auxiliary space required is order of 1, it means that space complexity is constant, it is in place sorting, and also it is stable sorting. So hope this video was useful. Thanks for watching.